Are you interested in flying big rockets like level 2 or level 3 rockets, and you're worried about the electronics? That's what I'm going to cover in this video.
Welcome to Advanced Construction Videos, where we show you how to tackle rocketry building techniques and more. On our website, we sell kits, motors, building supplies, and electronics. So come and learn, shop, build, and fly when you visit us at apogeerockets.com.
Hi, I'm Tim Vab Milligan from Apogee Components. When you start flying electronics to control dual deployment and to do other things in your rocket, you might want to consider using redundant systems. And that's what I want to talk about today. So redundant systems essentially means two of everything in the electronics bay. And the reason for that is if one system fails, you have a backup system that will take over. Now, here on this eBay, I have some systems set up. It's not quite redundant, but I wanted to kind of show you what's involved. So primarily, you're going to have two altimeters. So I got one altimeter right here on this side. And then if I flip the board over, I have another one on the other side. So I have two altimeters. And you can see on each side, I actually have two ejection charges. Now, this is the one spot where you can have one ejection charge on each side, because the reason is that any of the altimeters, any of the igniters is going to fire that off. So you don't need to have two of them like we do here. Now, the reason I have two of them is because we're testing out a brand new altimeter. We were, in fact, testing out this lightning bug altimeter, and we wanted to make sure that it uses a plasma arc system to fire them off, and we wanted to make sure that it was working on both ends, but if it sets off just a one-charge well, we don't know if it was this that set it off or this one here on this side of the board that set it off. So that's one case where you might want to use redundant systems is if you're familiar with one altimeter, but you're not familiar with the other one, you can test them this way just to get yourself familiarized with the workings of the new altimeter that you have. Now, when you'd use redundant altimeters, you typically want to use from two different manufacturers. And the reason for that is that there might be firmware problems in the altimeter, and you don't want the same problem to affect both altimeters inside the rocket. So if they're made by two different manufacturers, they're going to have different software, and the bugs, if there was any bugs in the software, they wouldn't overlap. Now, the electronics that we use in today's rockets, I trust them completely. You know, they're reliable. I've never seen one fail. Not that I've seen every one of them fly, but they are really reliable. So I don't personally worry about firmware in the software on board the altimeter as being a problem. You also want to have two switches. Now, on this particular board, we only had one switch. But when you do redundant, you do want two switches. This particular switch, it doesn't look like a switch, but it's actually a magnetic switch. And to turn it on and off, you slide a magnet past it. And this would sense that magnetic field and trigger the altimeter to turn on. You know, you don't have to use a magnetic switch, just two switches will work. Also on this one, we only have one battery. And this is a no-no for doing redundant systems. You want to use two batteries in case there's a problem with the battery. Either the battery is draining, like it's a low battery, or if you have an overvoltage problem, you don't want it affecting both altimeters. So definitely two batteries. So two switches, two batteries, and two different altimeters. And that will be the redundancy that you need for your dual deployment system. Because you have two of everything, you have to be really careful when you're prepping the rocket for flight. Now, on this particular board, I've got a spaghetti bowl of wires right here. And it's really easy to get the wires into the wrong terminals on your altimeters. So either use color-coded wires or label your wires. You know, just put a piece of masking tape and label, you know, right on the masking tape where that wire should be going to, so that when you get onto the launch field, you know exactly where you should insert it into your altimeter. This is one of the most common causes of failures, is things that were wired incorrectly. You know, they're flipped, they're into the wrong ports, and you don't notice it. One of the problems that you often will have with dual deployment altimeters is they beep at you to let you know that they're turned on. Well, when you got two of them beeping at you at the same time, it can be a little bit confusing. So sometimes you might not hear the beep when you should be hearing a beep. And you know, that might be an indication that your wires are reversed. So get to know your altimeters really well. Test them before you go out and fly them. So where can failures occur? Now, I'm going to read this off. Martin McKee wrote this for me. So Martin is like really smart electronics. He says, redundant electronics can fail due to many factors such as firmware bugs. And this is what I talked about. It's kind of like the software inside the electronics itself. Unexpected conditions that you don't expect. That's why they're unexpected. Human error in preparation, vibration and shock. And this was, you have to be very careful about electronics with the batteries. You know, if things aren't connected firmly, you know, when the rocket takes off, it's vibrating and it could disconnect. So you do have to worry about that. Inappropriate voltages, mechanical failure in the switches or in the electronics themselves. So all of those things are the types of things that you have to be aware of when you're doing redundant electronics. Now, you are required to do redundancy when you do a level 3 rocket, but it's not required for a level 2 rocket. So I would suggest, you know, getting to know your electronics first in level 2, fly it with redundancy on a different flight before you take it up into your level 3 rocket. We do have more information about setting up redundant systems, and that's in Peak of Flight newsletter number 322. And it kind of explains why you want redundancy and where it can fail. Typically, just 2 altimeters is all you need. You're not going to need 3 altimeters. In fact, when you get more than 2, then other problems occur. So this was about redundant electronics. My name is Tim Van Milligan. This is the Apogee Rocketry Workshop. May the winds be light, may the skies be blue, and may all your rockets fly straight and true.